So I think stenosis is one of these terms you hear about all around in the field of medicine, and it can raise a lot of concern. So we're going to focus on lumbar spinal stenosis, okay? Now, stenosis just means narrowing of the space, okay? So if you think about it, we can have stenosis of our arteries impeding the blood flow. We can have spinal stenosis narrowing the space of the nerves in our back, okay? Think about it. If we have a brand new pipe and things are flowing through it, no problem. If sludge starts to build up in there, narrowing the space, that's stenosis, okay? And if we think about the lumbar spine or the low back, right? If we look into the low back, it's a series of bones, vertebra, and discs, one on top of another. And then the nerves are running right in this area. They're running up and down, just like a cable inside a conduit pipe, okay? Now, when we're young and we're healthy, there's lots of space around the nerves. Now, there are some people that were actually born with less space around their nerves than average. That's called congenital stenosis. That sounds really scary, congenital, but just means you were born that way. It's not necessarily a problem, but if you start out with less space, then you get into trouble faster as life goes on. Now, if we look at this cartoon, as we live our lives, our discs will naturally become less elastic over time, like the rest of us. We start to get wrinkles and we start to get a, you know, rotator cuff tendonitis. And if the discs start to degenerate a bit, that can start to let your bones narrow together. And over time, the discs can further degenerate, even bulging out. And if the discs or other arthritis encroach into that area, that's called lumbar spinal stenosis. Okay. Now, what does lumbar spinal stenosis cause? It can be a bunch of different things, but most people, it's like really bad pain in the low back or like the buttocks. And sometimes it goes down the leg. Now, there's a lot of things we can do to diagnosis just talking to people. In fact, you know, a lot of those people will say, hey, the more I walk, the worse it hurts. I've got to lean over the shopping cart. And as soon as I sit down, it goes away. Like, I know that's lumbar spinal stenosis. But there are a lot of different things that can cause back pain. One of them is spinal stenosis pinching the nerves. But for some people, degeneration of the discs might be causing pain as well, or arthritis in other joints in the spine. So when we're seeing pain here, we have to understand, is this spinal stenosis? Is it degeneration of the discs? Is it muscle problems? Is it other types of arthritis? Getting that understood really, really well is critical before recommending any type of surgery, because if somebody has problems from spinal stenosis and bad discs and other arthritis, and you only do something to open up the space around the nerves, their pain may not go away because those other things are still problems. And that is a really common reason for what we call failed back surgery. And really what that is surgeon goes in, opens up space around the nerves, patient doesn't feel better. And that's commonly because one of these other structures was involved from the get-go, but it just didn't get fully treated with the surgery. Now, this is a cross-sectional view. So if we think of a vertebra and now we rotate it, this is looking right down the space. So this is the space where the nerves are running. And if we think about what stenosis it would be if arthritis or ligaments start to come into that space and narrow. Okay. And so if we look at the MRI, this is a side view of someone's lumbar spine. We can see normal disc here. And down here, we're starting to see some bone spurs. You can see the space for the disc is narrowing. And when we go from the x-ray to the MRI, those discs are starting to come back into the space of the nerves. So a normal space for the nerves is this white area here. As we go lower for this patient, we're starting to see this material pinch the nerves. And if we were to take what we call a cross-sectional view, like we're cutting the body like a summer sausage, if we take one up here and look at the nerves, see this white area? Well, that's the space where the nerves, and those are the little nerves just running in there. Now, if we take a cross-section a little bit lower and we show you what the nerves look like, we can see that that space is narrowed quite a bit. And so look at this picture here as it goes to the next. We now see a lot less space, right? And instead of seeing those little nerves as separate little dots, we see this stuff is all crushing them into the one place. And so now this is someone who can't walk and can't be active and can't do the things they want to do. Now, this amount of spinal stenosis is getting pretty severe. So many times when we see it to this level, it is a discussion of surgery. There are many people who have a more mild version and we just need to get them in shape. We lose weight, we strengthen our core. We do different injections into this area. That's a whole other topic of which injection is best. But once we start to see really bad pain, nerve damage, a surgery can really make sense. Now, One possibility is a surgery where you go in and try and simply remove some of this to give the nerve space to reinflate. And if someone's pain is all coming from spinal stenosis, that surgery can be just amazing for them. However, if someone is also having pain from bad discs, arthritis, or other issues, just doing a surgery to make space around the nerves may not help them because those other issues continue to persist. And this is where we really need to be careful to understand. One patient with spinal stenosis, a microsurgery to make more space may be awesome. Another patient may actually need a fusion or some other type of procedure, depending on which different things are actually causing their pain. Now, if we look at this, this thing right here, this is the bone that sticks out of your back, right? And especially in somebody who's thin, you can see all those bones. Well, those are called spinous processes. And they're really important because all these muscles and ligaments and everything attach, right? Like all the cables to a circus tent. Now, a common way that people treat spinal stenosis surgically is to go in the back and cut the bone on each side and lift that whole bone out. And you can imagine if you do that, there's a lot more space for the nerves, right? It's like lifting the whole roof off your house to make space in your attic. That's great at opening up space for the nerves, but that takes away this important bone and all the muscles that attach to it. And so for some people, then that can lead to more issues down the road because the spine starts to get instability. It's not supported properly. And so when we do need to make more space for the nerves, we really like to do a procedure where we go in more minimally invasive, leaving this, and we make little windows in the bone, removing this material, but preserving the bone and the ligament and all the muscular attachments. Now, it is true. I usually do it that way if I can. It takes a little bit longer. I do think surgeons might find it a little more time consuming or frustrating. But if you have spinal stenosis and need surgery, and we can preserve those bones and ligaments, I think there's a huge benefit in terms of how your back's going to hold up down the road. So here's an MRI. Next, watch this picture. We're going to go to an example of the same spot after surgery. And so we can now see, actually, it's a slightly bit above, but we can now see this is a little window. This is fluid right after surgery. And you can see how much space has been created around the nerves there. And you can also see that bone is still there. So we went in like on a little path, opened up all this area, but we left the joints, we left the bones. And that's really better for people's stability down the road, especially in someone like this, where the nerves are actually pinched in multiple areas. So if we go in and remove all those bones and ligaments to unpinch, we really worry that the spine is not going to have good stability down the road. So in terms of deciding if this is right for this patient, we were pretty confident this stenosis was the big issue. But what we did is we actually did an injection of medicine around the nerves. And when we did that before surgery, the pain got way, way better. It didn't last, but we learned something. And then we actually did some injections into the other joints and the discs of the spine. And it turned out those weren't really hurting. And so by being really careful, we could really be sure this is going to help you because your pain is all from spinal stenosis. If we found that the pain was actually coming from some other type of problem, then it might have been that a whole different surgery might have been necessary to avoid, you know, having a bad result.